Hi everyone, today I will show you how to update BIOS for 500 series Giga mainboard. If you cannot update for this mainboard, so this video is for you. Sorry for my English, it sometimes like hiccup, so forgive me. So first, take a look at my computer. This is my mainboard. Here you see, it's the same as this website about my mainboard. I find it. And this is my version of BIOS. Take a look. I think this new mainboard and new Intel, it really, really, in my opinion, it really, really good budget for run virtual program like Android Studio, VMware, this one, it really, really smooth. So back to our story. We did new mainboard. There is many way to update BIOS. So, but there is two main way. Get into the BIOS, and tour window. When you get into the BIOS, we have a new way. Quick plus. In the same old way, but this way is too risky. I don't recommend it. You can close warranty, and your mainboard is going to the backers. So let's check the second. The second way, you need to update to the window. First, let's check your mainboard. Model name and which revision here. So I have three methods to take. First, you can check to MS info and this system here. So you can see your mainboard, this one, and your BIOS version here. But it is more hard to find. So I will show you the second one. It is to look at one. The second way, did you see? This one. The other. So here, you can see my main bar, my BIOS version here. I can find my version of here. My main bar. I can find my version here. So the third and the fourth way I will try here. This is CPU this. Here you can CPU test mainboard. Well, you can see here. This is your model of your mainboard. This is your revision, but it is the new one. So it not charge as update this. This is charge a default thing. So they nothing. Let's try the four ones. So open Windows PowerShell or Command Room, this one, then you pass this one. This one I will show you later in the description. Copy, then pass it in. Enter. So your manufacturer by technology company, products here, serial number and version. Did it not show yes? The code is just a new one. So you have to know which version of your mainboard and model when you buy. So this one, after all, if you want to update, be sure it is just the same mainboard. This one a lot of revision, so be sure. Like this mainboard, there are some revision 1.1, revision 1.3.0, revision 2.0 here. Then you find your BIOS version with this one here. This one's here. So compare to your version, this one here, and check the description. some you can find here. This is reason. Some reason require to update before you update the newest one. So let's find to the window you find here. The app center of ours need on at iOS. You see we show here. The information about Minbox. You have two way here. Update from server and update from line. Let's try this first. You can try the newest, the latest, the closest from your area. I will show this one. You can see here, warning, fail. I have tried on, so they are on the same results. So try this one. I have already out of here. So let's find it. Okay. This one here. No, this one. This one here. Okay. Things here. Neatness. You have to read it carefully. So after read it, you click OK. Save or not. I don't need to save. So please wait. Read by OS file. So fine, let's find out here. This one, this one. Extract this fly and then read this one. Download the iOS file from the GitHub website. Unzip it to the root directory of the bootable USB plus file. You will need edit the content of plus dot nhh file and change the text in the red frame to the correct iOS name. So let's change it. File is here. You see this is the name of the 490 hours matter dot f3. So change it to this one. Save it. Let copy it to the USB flash drive. This one. This one, then servers back again. This one, be sure this one, leave be sure this format is NTA FAT32. So format it, you don't want to problem. This file style. Okay. And copy it in again. After that, leave be sure. This one, USB. This one. Then you can do it. This one. Here. Okay. Net. And it will be okay. I have already do that, so I don't want to do it again. I have already customized iOS. So this one, you need to check carefully your pH use, electricity, and all the thing, the cable of SSD, the SSD Sabisu did not corrupt the rosette. If it occurs, your main block cannot put again. At the last video, I will show you the Esper had already do it. So, end video here.